I come from conventional agriculture, and all I ever wanted to do growing up was become a farmer. When I left high school, I went straight to the Monero and started my wool classing certificate. I went to TAFE and did a bunch of courses. And if you'd asked me back then where I'd be when I'm 47, I'd be on a farm somewhere in the Southern Tablelands or the Monero, farming sheep and living happily ever after. The cost of feed for farming is 70% of all production costs. So every time I tried to look at the business model for creating a small farm, I kept running into this problem of how do I pay for it and make it an efficient business, because small farm holding is really tight margins and feed was the biggest problem. My passion about climate and my passion for farming have always been sort of symbiotic to each other, and the idea that you could change farming systems in a way that created sustainability and more resilient farms has always been something attractive to me. Managing food waste with maggots does a lot of things. When I first started farming insects, I can't say that I was completely enamoured with the idea. And so to find myself in a warehouse coaxing flies to mate and then pleading for larvae to stay alive, I didn't really fully appreciate how exciting that was going to be. We knew the insects would eat the waste, and we knew that when they ate the waste, they converted it into a highly nutritious protein that can be used as farm feed. And then they also created excreta, which is manure that can turn into fertiliser for farms. But how I fed them commercially was the problem. And so if I could create a technology that harnessed this capability and had a commercial application, then we've solved the issue. The robot knows every day it needs to draw waste from the holding hopper where that waste has been processed and to take it into the robotic system to feed the insects, where they're consuming 5 times their body weight plus every day. We do this for 10 days with the system feeding itself and the insects consuming the waste throughout that period of time. Instead of waiting for 12 weeks for something to compost, we are reducing GHG emissions by significant amounts. So 1,700 CO2 equivalent kilos of GHG emissions are created when you send food waste to landfill per tonne, and only 35 kilos of CO2 equivalent is created when you send the same amount of waste to insects. We realised that the problem we were solving had significant impacts, more than what we'd first believed. And we're going to continue to do this work meaningfully, because it matters so much, not just economically and to create resiliency within our communities, but also environmentally in the efforts to reduce GHG emissions in this, the decisive decade. So we're on a mission.
All of these evolutions in how we think about interacting with climate change are creating positive impacts in progressing both the technology and the innovation, but continuing to change the sort of political and social will, which are both required to be in tandem and agreement in the action required. I look around and I see my peers in the startup climate tech world who are working on crazy, incredible, powerful, commercial-ready pieces of technology that could meaningfully change our course today, and I know we're going to be just fine.